Good morning and welcome to our service here on Trinity Sunday. Let us pray. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth and draw us more deeply into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. How often have I longed to gather your children as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, says the Lord. But you would not come to me. Let us, as wayward children, return to God and confess our sins together. Father, we have sinned against heaven and against you. We are not worthy to be called your children. We turn to you again. Have mercy on us. Bring us back to yourself as those who once were dead, but now have life through Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon, deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Our reading is taken from John's Gospel, chapter 3, beginning at the first verse. Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these signs that you do apart from the presence of God. Jesus answered him, Very truly I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above. Nicodemus said to him, How can anyone be born after already growing old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born? And Jesus answered, Very truly I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and of spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I said to you, You must be born from above. The winds blow where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the spirit. Nicodemus said to him, How can these things be? Jesus answered him, Are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive my testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe it if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one whom descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so the Son of Man must be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world, he gave his only Son, that so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Trinity Sunday always brings back fond memories for me, as it was the first time I preached in the chapel of St. Martin's College in Lancaster. Now that is going back a bit, as it was in 1996. I sometimes think that we don't give ourselves enough credit for knowing stuff. There are those who love a good quiz and those who dread it. I would hate to be on the Tarvin annual quiz and end up with a religious round and be a bit like our entry in the Eurovision Song Contest, sometimes with no points. There are so many analogies to try and show the Trinity so that we understand that three things are one. Ice, steam and water is always the obvious one to me. However, I don't have a wonderful display to show you, or indeed some combination of three things that you have never known before that were one. I'm going to rely on our combined intelligence. God is three things, Father, Son and Holy Spirit. Jesus answered, Very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and the Spirit. Our baptism is for us, some of us, an event that we may not remember if we were a child, and maybe we don't think about it very often. But the promises that were made or were made for us about changing our lives and being renewed by the water of baptism and being claimed as God's own through the sign of the cross on our foreheads, it is, however, what we do from then rather than what has been done to us. It is about how we support and help those around us and how we interact with our friends, our family and our strangers. Jesus tells Nicodemus that he was sent into the world to save it, not to condemn it. This is our role too, to look at ways of helping others, to save, not to condemn, to help rather than complain, to see what can be saved rather than dismissed and thrown away. That is the challenge that Jesus gives us in our world, in order that we might save the world. After all, we are the ones in Christ who bring hope to others in his name, peace and love. And in return, we will be filled by others with the hope, peace and love that they have received from Christ. The Trinity teaches us that in doing these things together, we become stronger, just as God is three and one, as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Father of heaven, whose love profound a ransom for our souls has found, we pray for the world, created by your love, and we pray for its nations and governments. Extend to them your peace, pardoning love, mercy and grace. Almighty Son, incarnate Word, our prophet, priest, redeemer, Lord, we pray for the church, created for your glory, for its ministry to reflect those works of yours. Extend to us your salvation, growth, mercy and grace. Eternal Spirit, by whose breath the soul is raised from sin and death, we pray for families and individuals created in your image, for the lonely, the bereaved, the sick and the dying. Breathe on them the breath of life and bring them to your mercy and your grace. Thrice holy Father, Spirit, Son, mysterious Godhead, three in one. We pray for ourselves, for your church, for all whom we remember before you, who have come to your eternal glory. Bring us all to bow before your throne in heaven, to receive life and pardon, mercy and grace for all eternity. And we offer these prayers as we join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory for ever and ever. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen.